afternoon. The Outstanding Science Awards in English, Foreign Language, Mathematics, Science, and Social Studies are presented to seniors who have earned a minimum of 4 credits in the subject area. The students must have achieved a minimum 3.0 GPA, taken high academic courses, and exhibit exemplary attitudes and demeanor. The Outstanding Senior Science Award in Science, based on GPA, having completed multiple AP courses and being a prestigious student, goes to Chang Wu Li, AKA
this. And this is for my wife, who was a teacher here. This is the Fingaleno Memorial Award. And it is given in memory of Jenny Fingaleno, who taught in Wicomico County for 27 years. She dedicated her life to helping students with special needs as they could reach their greatest potential while in school and hoping afterwards in their daily lives. This year, the $500 Scholarship Memorial Award is given to Douglas Bach.
Is 1% of our military. Very rare. Tonight's award is given to a young man who's worked hard and who has committed himself to our program here at Wicomico High School for the past 4 years. He is entering the United States Army this summer. Very proud of him, Mr. James Winter.
Kids of Honor empowers young people to graduate from high school and pursue their dreams. We recognize students in upper elementary school and middle school who need a little push. After demonstrating some dedication to education, we award them a $500 scholarship at that point in time. And then we invest those funds in a CD. And Erica, you can now use this to pursue your dreams.
The Lori Hopper Scholarship Fund is given in honor of my father. 1970, he was the founder and partner of the local Arby's franchise here in Salisbury. In 1977, he and a group of parents formed the Y.I. Booster Club. He was elected the club's first president. Prior to his death in 1991, he was married for 45 years and raised 5 children. He taught that hard work and dedication pays off. The winner of the 2017 award has lettered in lacrosse and soccer during 4 years. She was captain of the lacrosse and the soccer teams for 3 years. Her GPA is 4.37 and has been accepted to Salisbury University. The winner is Marion Jabagot.
Hoping for our community to benefit to these individuals who receive the scholarships and thus it gives a sort of enduring benefit. Education equips students to consider perspectives different from their own, and lives, effective leadership, and citizenship are the basis of our democratic country. Robin Hood wished to even it out, that was his version of fair chances. Education is the foundation of our democracy, as I said, and increases the opportunity to even out what we see as fair. In conjunction with the Community Foundation of the Eastern Shore, an expert management team, and the Wicomico County School High School Faculty Selection Committee, our class of 1963 is able to award what we consider to be the maximum benefit of the book to students. We're very proud to be a part of this teamwork. It is said that money's value increases when you spend it on things that are important to you, and when you can make your money even more valuable by making sure it's important to you, becomes your legacy. Our legacy, we hope, is of enduring community benefit. Recipients of the 2017 1963 class scholarship are Young Ho and Casey Lynn Mills.
Two scholarships for the Jake Shirks Academic Wrestling Scholarship. 2017 is the first year for this scholarship to be offered, and as parents, we couldn't be happier for the winners. They met all the requirements and exhibit the traits that Jake would be proud of and would put a smile on his face knowing that they are the first recipients. He would also hope that this scholarship would help others achieve their goals and leave a legacy in Jake's name. Jake was a very thrifty and hardworking young man. He was able to earn and save a substantial amount of money from his summer jobs, and we knew he would want his money to be given to deserving academic wrestlers. This scholarship was started by the suggestion of a few close people, and we have been accepting donations as well as Jake's own money since his passing. We'd like to thank all the people who had made donations to this scholarship. Jake loved wrestling and knew that through hard work and 100% effort and teamwork and academic skills, you could do anything in life that you wanted or dreamed of. He set a great example for young people to follow, and we are forever grateful for all the time that we had to share with him. We'd like to call up Noah Lawson and Isaac Lawson. We'd like to congratulate both of these young men, friends, and wrestling teammates of Jake for their hard work and their effort to earn this scholarship.
Since none of you graduating this year had the privilege of being in his classroom, And you need to know what kind of person he was. Mr. Say had a presence not just defined by his 6'4" stature or his menacing faces, the kind that could intimidate kids and adults alike, but by his caring demeanor, which helped define who he was as a teacher. When Mr. Say was your teacher, you didn't have much chance to be right in a discussion. No matter which stance you took, he took the opposite. And because of this, he created some pretty amazing debaters in his 16 years teaching at Y High. He also inspired many of his students to become some pretty amazing teachers. Upon his death, though, the thing I heard from more people than anything was that it didn't matter how much he knew about US history or European history, and he did know more than everybody, but that he cared about every single student. Who passed through his classroom door. And not just a superficial, how are you today, kind of care. He was genuinely concerned with the well-being of all his kids, and they were all his kids. The winner of the Richard Say Memorial Scholarship is a student who has shown her compassion for others through her volunteerism with special needs students here at Y High and in the community. Ooh. I did it. This year's winner is Rebecca Ingram.
Provides scholarship to one graduating senior in each of the 4 Wicomico County public high schools. The Future Educator Scholarship Award, in the amount of $1,000, will help the selected student pursue a degree in education. I hear a future teacher right over there. This year's recipient has chosen to become a teacher in order to, in her words, inspire and to motivate others. This recipient aspires to bring out the best, the talent of others, so that they will experience the same positive feelings and success in themselves. These are the qualities, the foundation of a dedicated teacher. And so with great pride, I present the Wicomico County Education Association Future Educator Scholarship Award to Miss Miranda Rotherman.
Congrats to all of you for the class of 2017, all the friends and family here this evening. The PTSA is able to provide 2 scholarships, and these recipients must be a current member of PTA, have a cumulative grade point average of 3.0 or higher, and believe in volunteering within the school, active in their sports, demonstrate service through different organizations while they're at Y High. Any of you that know me, I believe in volunteering, and that's one of the criteria that we strengthen with this scholarship. Applicants are also expected to have documented 75 plus service hours required, and are planning to attend a 2-year post-secondary school. And I am honored to award 2 scholarships this evening to 2 students that I've known for several years, Justin Tall,
Blake, who I also refer to as Maddie. Have been a member of at least two varsity athletic teams, as well as high standings. With recipient for this year's Athletic Booster and PTSA scholarship is Myreen Habagat. Finally, PTSA and Music Boosters supports a scholarship that has the same criteria mostly as athletic scholarship. They must be active in high school band, chorus, orchestra for a minimum of 2 years, and be a Y High student for those 2 years as well. I'm lucky enough to know this young gentleman through band. The recipient of this year's award goes to Skylar Sample.
Hi, my name is Amy Rose. I'm one of the counselors here at Y High. I'm giving out the Robert D. Evans Scholarship. Unfortunately, Mr. Evans couldn't be here with us tonight. The Robert D. Evans Scholarship is given annually to the senior who has met the qualifications of summa cum laude of 4.3 or higher on a weighted scale and has submitted a scholarly address judged to be the best from among other summa cum laude applicants. The purpose of the award is to encourage students to take and excel in a strong academic program. The student receives a scholarship to aid in advancing their educational goals. This year, the $1,000 scholarship is presented to Apeksha Kumar.
Good evening. My name is Rosemary Slagham, and I'm with the Wicomico Women's Club. We've been in existence, not me, but we've been in existence for 95 years. We've been giving scholarships to graduating high school seniors for many years. We give two $500 scholarships a year. Two go to, this year it's Y High, and then next year it will be Parkside and Mardell. We raise our scholarship money by selling Terry Lynn nuts. We're a small group, but we still are of service to people. This year, our recipient is very deserving. Her name is $500 scholarship, Dariana Ortiz.
Senior here at Wicomico High School. The Sons of American Revolution Award is given to a senior who has demonstrated loyalty to the high school and has performed excellent, has had excellent performance throughout their tenure here at Wicomico High School. Couldn't have gone to a better student, a better representative of our school, Dr. Neely, Rebecca, anyway.
The Optimist Club of Salisbury's motto is Friend of Youth, and each year awards for a scholarship to each Wicomico County High School and in Delmar High. The scholarship is presented to the senior who best exemplifies the following principles of optimism: outstanding scholastic achievement, outstanding school and community involvement, good sportsmanship and leadership, enthusiasm for self-development, and respect and consideration for others, and development of optimism as a philosophy of life. This scholarship is also a memory of Maurice L. Fields, Sr. Mr. Fields was a Y High graduate of the class of 1939. He was a founding member of the Eastern Shore Baseball Hall of Fame, a longtime member of the Salisbury Optimist Club, and a true friend of you. It's a pleasure for the Optimist Club to award this year's scholarship in the amount of $1,500 to Joan Ho.
Presented by Delegate Sharice Ample Hughes, District 37A.
The individuals that are being the recipients tonight are Chandra O'Connell, Rogera Pope, Braxton Clark, and last but not least, Skylar Sample. While I'm up here, right before my colleague presents his, I want to also take this opportunity to present Senator Addie Eckhart. She could not be with us this evening. She's in Cambridge at another graduation, but she wanted to recognize that Skylar Sample is her recipient of the 2017 Scholastic Award.
Good evening, everybody. How y'all doing?
Good evening.
Man, this ain't work. Good evening.
Good evening.
All right, now I was at another high school last night on College Avenue. Colors are red. They made a lot of noise, so can you beat them?
Yeah!
I think you beat them. All right, try. Right on. Good evening, everybody. I am blessed to represent many of you in Annapolis. And as honored to be here this evening, I am presenting one scholarship on behalf of our colleague Mary Beth Carosa, who could not be here. So if Maureen Habegat Justin Tall. Shariah Mills. I'm going to flash the signs to her. She knows what that means. W is for Wicomico. June O, could you make your way down to the end of the film? There you go. Oh, did we lose everybody? Did we stay on and hang out? Because you know we got to take a selfie with everybody. So, you know how we do.
Skylar,
Chandra,
Braxton, and Rogera.
Recipients have to maintain a 3.25 grade point average and enroll in consecutive fall spring terms. And I'm happy to award the Board of Trustees Scholarship to Noah Lawson. I'm happy to award the Salisbury Optimist Club Scholarship to Rebecca Ingram. I'll announce the second scholarship, the Max Cooley Scholarship. And that's $1,500 in scholarship funds for the 2017-18 academic year. It must be a graduate of public or private high school in Wicomico County. It's based on full-time enrollment in any credit program in Warwick. And I'm very happy to award both the Max Cooley Scholarship and the Optimist Club Scholarship to Rebecca Ingram. Before I step off the stage, I just want to mention that the Wicomico Economic Impact Scholarship is still available. You have until the end of this month, next week, to apply for that, and that's full tuition and fees for up to 3 years to make two at Warwick Community College. So the qualifying recipients can get free tuition and fees to Warwick for up to 3 years to earn a degree and then transfer on to any four-year institution. So congratulations to those who are participating in that program as well. Thank you.
Salisbury, Maryland, Club Matt Chapter, Cap Outside Security Incorporated, awarded a young man a scholarship for outstanding performance and dedication in community service, leadership, and academic achievement. This year's one-time scholarship of $500 goes to Skylar Sinclair.
Since then, the sorority has flourished into a globally impact organization of over 290,000 college trained members. Bound by the bonds of sisterhood and empowered by a commitment to servant leadership to both domestic and international UNISCO. As Alpha Kappa Alpha has grown, it has maintained its focus in two key arenas: the lifelong personal and professional development of each of its membership and galvanizing its membership into an organization of respected power and influence. Consistently at the forefront of effective advocacy and social change that results in equality and equity of all citizens of the world. It is my pleasure to award Ms. Julia Hester with the Agnes B. Riley Academic Peace Scholarship.
Army gives one male and one female students who exemplify the scholar athlete. the United States Army Reserve National Scholar Athlete Award. So it's my honor this year to present Bailey Truitt and Jason Patterson.
Scholarship Award for the amount of $750 to Joan F. Salisbury, Maryland is a service organization dedicated to helping meet the needs of people who are deaf or hard of hearing and disadvantaged women and children of our community. Over the past 80 years, our club has provided assistance for many local, national, and international causes. We are proud to sponsor a scholarship award to a senior in each of the Wicomico County High Schools, recognizing students who demonstrated outstanding leadership and service to the community. This year's recipient of the $1,000 Corey International Salisbury Award is Chantel Hardy.
Good evening. My name is Nikki Blake, a member of the Princess Anne Alumni Chapter of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority. On the behalf of the membership of Princess Anne Alumni Chapter of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated, a public service sorority is interested in providing financial assistance to further the academic training of minority students. This year, we proudly present the $750 Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated Award is presented to Scholar Sample.
My name is Max Berwitz. I'm an architect here at Salisbury. And I'd like to call up David Sullivan Sanchez. Here on behalf of all my fellow mentors, we are architects, engineers, and contractors that meet students from grades 9 through 12 from all schools. This past season, we had students from Wyhot, Parkside, and Bennett. And we meet for about 20 sessions. We take 3 field trips, and we work on a design project, actually. Using an existing site, an existing building. And this particular project this year was taking the downtown park pump building. Some of you may know that across the street from the Y building. And we kind of went on the concept that that building was going to be decommissioned, and the students had to come up with an idea on how to repurpose that building. David was our lead architect. What inspired us mentors to award him a scholarship for the amount of $1,250, which was the highest amount awarded, was for all the time and dedication. David pretty much took the lead on building the model, developing the design, and more importantly, he pretty much self-taught himself having worked the program, modeling program. Wonderful student, great job, put in a lot of effort, and the project was truly one of the best projects we've ever had at present. So, this is a special recognition, acknowledges that David Teller-Sanchez is a scholarship recipient and the ACE Mentor Salisbury Program. Congratulations from all the mentors from ACE Mentor. We admire your dedication, and it was our pleasure to watch your enthusiasm grow. Both for the program and the field of
architecture. Wish you all success in the mission of the culture.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Jill Smith, and as a lifetime member of the Wicomico County Council of PTAs, I'm very pleased to be able to present the Roy Day Mahaffey PTA Scholarship. Every year, the Wicomico County Council of PTAs awards a graduating senior in each of the four county high schools with the Roy A. Mahaffey Scholarship. This award is in memory of Mr. Mahaffey, who served as Wicomico County Superintendent of Schools from 1957 until his death in 1975. Applicants must have been accepted to an accredited degree-granting post-secondary institution. Factors considered are academic performance, community activities, financial need, extracurricular, and PTA participation. This year's recipient of the $500 scholarship is Miss Danielle Lorette.
Of the 5,338 finalists, just 767 students were awarded scholarships by a partner school. Our own Steve Lee matched at Haverford College, a liberal arts college in the suburbs of Philadelphia. He will attend, beginning in the fall of 2017,
While he has not declared a major, he has a keen interest in mathematics and the natural sciences. Jung O plans to attend the University of Maryland in College Park and major in international relations. However, she is also waiting to hear from Wellesley College, a Quest Ridge partner school to which she was waitlisted. These two students could come up. I think it's fitting. They will get a keychain that says, go where there is no path and leave a trail.
I know it's been a long night. I'm not going to keep you guys here long. I usually have a nice drawn-out speech. I think I'll save it for you, though. I got several awards I want to hand out tonight, but I want to thank the parents and the staff for allowing me to come out here and talk. These four awards, as I call your guys' name, please come up to the stage and hold your applause until we get all four of them up here. The first award is called the Scholastic Excellence. It's given to the student with the most who display scholar achievements as a leader here in high school. The first one is Chang Lee. The next two awards, Distinguished Athlete Awards, it's given out to a male and female from the high school, Madison Andrews and Devin Phillips. And lastly, the fourth award I'm giving out tonight, this is for musical excellence. We call it the Semper Fidelis Award. Semper Fidelis means always faithful. This year's Semper Fidelis Award goes to Rachel Beard. Picture that for a second. How many ghosts are standing around you right now? I say that because when you walk out of those doors, life is going to hit you. It's going to hit you hard. But you have to stand. You have to stand for something. Stand for your dreams. Stand for peace of mind. Stand for health. Stand. So that one day, those dreams will be memories. Again, my name is Sergeant DePiro, and I'm your local Marine Corps representative.
My name is Juan Bratton. This is the principal here at Wicomico High School. We will have a long list that will be presented by all three assistant principals. So if you could hold your applause until we finish the list, that would be greatly appreciated. I will be presenting the President's Educational Award for Educational Achievement. The purpose of this award is to recognize students that show outstanding educational growth, improvement, and commitment to intellectual development. It is meant to encourage and reward students who work hard and give their best effort in school, having achieved an unweighted GPA between 3.0 and 3.5. This year, the President's Educational Award for Educational Achievement goes to Nathan Adams, Philip Boyer, Ja'Kai Grayboy, Braxton Clark, Shania Crosby, Taylor Davis, Alyssa Earp, Charles Edson, Mason Elsie, Carl Estime, Dynasty Etienne, Jasmine Fuller, Terrence Gaines.
Continue with the President's Achievement Award, Chantel Handy.
Shaquem Handy, Burgundy Hayward, Connor Horwath, Seth Jones, Erica Kelly, Jared LeBar, Shervelle Lightfoot, Alexander Littleton, Jasmine Lyles, Rubama Mahmood, Cameron Mann, Raquan McCarter, Aaliyah Meadows, Brennan Meredith, Amaya Murray.
Next, we'll have Jason Patterson, Keyasia Brunell, Miranda Rothbard, Sandy Santil, Aaliyah Savage, Jacob Savage, Tasia Shiles, Anaya Singletary, Robert Smith, Wilson St. Seren, Victoria Tarr, Deshaun Taylor, Ashley Truitt, Brianna Ward Middleton, Kelsey Watson, Rashaya Warden, Tamara Williams, Joseph Wood, and Madeline Zaprowski. Sorry. Give me a round of applause, please.
This year's recipients are Madison Andrews, Caitlin Beach, Ayanna Bethune, Rachel Beer, Jacob Mazzari, Jayla Blount, Brianna Branch, Stefan Clark, Cameron Cody, Jessica Demas, Samantha Davis, Kamisha Dennis, Emily Dickerson, and Apeshka Gumarkar. Rebecca Ingraham, Myrene Havagat, Rhonda Joynes, Catherine Laguerre, Danielle Laurent, Isaac Lawson, Noah Lawson, Chang Lee, Taylor McLean, Shariah Mills, Michaela Morris, Shelby Morris, Catherine Nolan, Caslyn Nicholas, Joan O, Dariana Ortiz Galvez, Joshua Overton.
The Above and Beyond Award is given to the student who has excelled in areas other than academics. The student will have made positive changes from freshman through senior year of high school, showing academic, social, and emotional growth. This year's recipient has met all of that criteria and more. She has even surprised herself with her own abilities. This year's award recipient is Erica Gladden.
Outstanding community service. Martin King to a graduating senior at Wicomico High School who has demonstrated an outstanding commitment to community service throughout his or her high school career. A permanent plaque to which the name of the recipient will be added is displayed in the school office. This year's $500 Martin Kane Award, with a total of $1,587.5 hours of community service, is Chantel Handy.
We at Wicomico High School participated in the Graduate from Oz College and Career Preparation Program. The Graduate from Oz program awarded only five $1,000 scholarships in the entire country, and one of our students was one of the recipients. To apply, the student must have completed the College Dollars Badge, which included an essay. The winners were selected based on the quality and persuasive answer to the essay prompt. The winner of one of the $1,000 national scholarships is Apeksha Gumakar.
The Norman H. Conway Scholarship is awarded annually to Wicomico High School graduates who are involved in their community and have been accepted for full-time enrollment at Salisbury University, University of Maryland Eastern Shore, or Warwick Community College. The recipients must have a 3.0 GPA. The recipient of the Norman H. Conway Scholarship is awarded a $500 scholarship, and that is Samantha Davis.
Next, we'll have our Exemplary Service Learning Hours recognition. It's awarded to seniors who have obtained at least 300 service learning hours, and the recipients are Denia Diaz, Cameron Cody, Samantha Davis, Jessica Demas, Jacob Bazzari, Shariah Mills, Taylor McQueen, Dariana Ortiz-Galvez, Cameron Mann, Justin Tall, Apeksha Gumakar, and Destiny Fisher. Those students are Caitlin Beach, Ayana Boone, Chantel Handy, Rebecca Ingram, Kathleen Nicholas, Shelby Morris, Joshua Robinson, Anya Turner, Stephon Clark, and Rachel Beer.
Leadership capability, service to community,
as well as a perception of future promise. Letters of recommendation and an essay is also considered in determining the recipient. The recipient of the $1,000 Rotary Club of Wicomico County Scholarship is Skylar Sand.
Given in memory of Sam Seidel, is given to a senior athlete who has participated in at least two sports each year during grades 10, 11, and 12. The intent of the award is to give recognition to the student who has participated as a team member, who has excelled academically, but not solely in the academic curriculum. The award in the amount of $996.80, this year's Seidel Student Athletic Award is presented to Shariah Mills.
It is my pleasure to award the BFW Post 2996 Scholarship. Applicants for the BFW Post 2996 Scholarship must be graduates of Parkside or Wicomico High Schools in Wicomico County who have selected their college or university and have been accepted for administration admission as a full-time student. Recipients must attend an accredited 2 or 4 year institution of higher education. They must have demonstrated academic achievement, ranked in the top 25% of the graduating class, been involved in school extracurricular activities, community activities, or part-time work. They should also display a positive attitude along with respect and consideration for others. This year's recipient of the $1,000 scholarship is Madeline White.
Thank you.
4.29 and have earned the Magna Cum Laude distinction. Jacob Bazzari, Cameron Cody, Samantha Davis, Rebecca Ingraham, Danielle Lawrence, Shariah Bill, Catherine Dahman, Ryan Rangel, Bailey Truitt.
Those qualities of heart and mind and meek for righteousness and good citizenship. Mr. Gumby established the following criteria: not necessarily the highest standing in scholarship, but deportment, attendance, punctuality, initiative, effort, pleasant relationship with teachers and pupils, the boys to be a gentleman, the lady, the girl a lady. The recipients of the Francine Merriman Gumby Award are Savannah Wood and Tyrese Withers.
Success through the acceptance of responsibilities in the extracurricular program, reasonable diligence in class activities, consideration of fellow students and faculty, and a good attendance record. The recipients are also pursuing post-secondary education. The two recipients of this $250 scholarship are Brianna Hickman and Tyrese Williams.
The announcing the Elizabeth Brigham QC Scholarship. These are three $1,500 awards are given by the Community Foundation in memory of Elizabeth Brigham QC to graduating seniors who have been accepted for admissions as full-time students is renewable up to 4 years. Students must be in the top 10% of the class. This year's recipients are Cameron Cody, Rachel Beer, and Skylar Sample.
Maturity and commitment to succeed in college-level courses of study. The scholarship in the amount of $1,500 goes to Stefan Clark.
I will now be presenting the Elks Most Valuable Student Scholarship. Each year, the Elks Club of Salisbury awards one $2,000 scholarship to each of the high schools in Wicomico County. This award has the earliest deadline of all scholarships from the Wicomico County area available to students. Students considered for this award must be academically motivated, have excellent SAT or ACT scores, involved in extracurricular activities, and demonstrate leadership skills. This year's recipient is Samantha Davis.
The Green Hill Young Country Cup Scholarship is awarded to graduates of a high school in Somerset, Wicomico, or Worcester counties who have been accepted for admission as a full-time student in an accredited four-year college or university, or an accredited two-year educational or vocational institution. The recipient of the $1,000 scholarship is Myrene Habaga.
Carr, Brianna Branch, Chang Lee, Jacob Whittington, John Poe, Caitlin Beach, Madeline White, Myrene Habaga, Noah Lawson, Rachel Beer, Shelby Morris, and Shariah Mills. Thank you, students, for being awesome. Have a great night, Wyatt.